Wait, why is a trio sonata being played by four people? The confusion lies in the title. The title in the first edition we see here is Sonata a Tre, which doesn't mean sonata for three instruments, but rather sonata for three melodic lines. In this case, two high voices and one bass line, to which chord symbols are added, known as figured bass or basso continuo. The bass line itself could be played by a violone, cello, viola da gamba, the keyboardist's left hand, organ pedals, etc., while the harmonies would be realized by the keyboardist's right hand, or a lute, or any number of other instruments. Thus, these sonatas would often be played by four or more instruments. The 20th century term Baroque trio sonata causes confusion because it implies three instruments rather than three melodic lines. Let's continue looking at Corelli's title page. The instrumentation is two violins and violone or arch lute with basso del organo. Basso del organo refers to the figured bass we see here. Indicating harmonies by chord symbols rather than written out notes has the advantage that chord symbols can be interpreted on a variety of instruments and realized idiomatically by each instrument. For example, a harpsichord, an arch lute, and a harp would each voice the same chord differently. Here's the title page of these sonatas from an edition by Joseph Joachim, published in 1888. The title here is Sonate da Chiesa, rather than Sonate a Tre, as it was in the original edition. The term Sonata da Chiesa refers to the structure of the sonata rather than the instrumentation. In the Baroque era, church services often included performances of secular music. Sonata da Chiesa refers to a church sonata in four movements, slow, fast, slow, fast, as opposed to a Sonata da Camera, which is a dance suite. In Bach's unaccompanied violin works, the sonatas are in a Sonata da Chiesa format, while the cello suites are mostly in a Sonata da Camera, or dance suite format. Baroque composers were often not very particular about instrumentation. For example, in these sonatas by Otter of 1712, the title is Sonatas in Trio Form for Traverse Flutes, Recorders, Violins, Oboes, etc. The parts were labeled Premier Dessus, or First Upper Voice, Second Dessus, or Second Upper Voice, and Basse. Salomon Rossi was a Jewish-Italian composer whose set of sonatas was published in Venice in 1613. The instrumentation we see in this original edition is two viola da braccios and a chitarrone, or other similar instrument. Viola da braccio is, of course, viola of the arm, which is the basis for the German word braccia. Chitarrone refers to a large bass lute. Looking at the very top of this page, we see the indication canto primo, meaning first voice. Now we see the canto secondo part, and now the basso part. We can see by the part names again that the instrumentation was flexible. This edition does not provide figured bass, however. Rossi provides an interesting indication at the end of the right page. Play the repeat faster. Thank you. Giorgio Antoniotti provided a figured bass in his sonatas of 1737, yet they are often played as cello and bass duos with no additional harmony instrument. Likewise flexible with his instrumentation, as we see in this original edition of his sonatas for two violins, two oboes, or two traverse flutes and basso continuo. Thank you. By the late 18th and early 19th centuries, instrumentation had become more fixed, and the use of basso continuo had gone out of fashion. Thus, the term trio came to indicate three instruments rather than three melodic lines. Thank you.
Thank you.